Good morning, everyone. It's Wednesday. Ready to dig back into God's Word together? I know I am. I love doing that with you. I really do. And this week, we're digging into a verse that most of us have memorized, John 3:16. And if you don't know it and you watch all these shows, you will know it. And if you already know it, then this is going to put a new depth to your understanding of this great, great verse. It's the most famous verse in the Bible for a reason. And that reason is it's a great verse. And it has the whole gospel right in it. The good news for the world. And that's where we come to John 3:16, for God, and we already went into great depth about God, so loved. And what love really is, we talked about yesterday. And how did he express that love? And to whom? So God so loved the world. The world. What's he mean by the world? And that's why I put it up as a background for us today. I just wanted you to see parts of the world. Because God so loved the whole world, the whole world, everything and everyone in it. And that's why he created it. He created it in how many days? 6 days. And what did God say at the end of each day? He saw what he had created and it was good, good. God doesn't create bad things. And by the way, of course, you remember after the sixth day, when he created mankind, he said it was very good, very good. Because that's the top of the difference between mankind and the rest of creation is that mankind is created in God's own image. It says in his image, he created them male and female. So, that was very good. God made no bad thing. And you know what? When he did that, it was love in action. And that's what we said about yesterday. Agape is action, not just feeling, action. And God showed his action by he loved the whole world. It was good. Now, of course, it changed because sin entered the world. And when sin entered the world, that meant death entered the world and suffering and all those things. They would not have happened if were it not for sin. But sin did happen and sin entered the world. But you see, agape, which we talked about yesterday, could not leave it that way. Love meant God had to do something to redeem the earth and mankind. So God so loved the world, he had to do something. Well, so what did he do? It's the next words. He, that is God, did what? He gave. Our God is a giving God. And he gave his only son. Wow. Let's just pause on that. He gave his son. Now understand, remember, God is a Trinity. So the Father gave the Son. But Ephesians 5 verse 2, a verse I really want you to consider right now, says, and live a life of love, he says to us, just as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering and a sacrifice to God. So God gave up his son. But his son, Jesus, part of the Trinity, also gave himself up. He gave himself up. Why? Well, it tells us, be a fragrant offering, but a sacrifice to God. Why was a sacrifice to God even necessary? Do you ever think about that? Because God is just. He's not just love, he's also just. And things have to be made right. And because he's holy, he can't allow sin into heaven. So there had to be some payment for sin so that sins could be forgiven forever. And that sacrifice given by Jesus was himself. Jesus went to the cross to sacrifice himself to justify the holiness of God himself. You see, that is God so what? Loved the whole world. He gave his son. He gave his only son. Part of himself. And you know that was so painful. For those of us who have ever lost a child, and I have not, so I can only try to relate, but I know some of you watching have, and I know that even just thinking about it is painful to my heart. And my heart goes out to you, anyone who has lost a child or a loved one, for that matter. We ache for that. We hate it. But God did it. He did it. Freely gave up his son. His son freely gave up his life. Remember what Jesus said? He was in agony over this in the Garden of Gethsemane. And he said, Father, if there's any way not to have this happen, please do that. Is there any other way? And he said, no. And so Jesus said, not my will be done, but yours, God. Why? Because agape love for you and I, so that, and we'll get to the rest of the verse and talk about what the ultimate meaning is, but basically it is so that we can live with him forever. Wow, talk about a gift. Talk about the best present in all of history. He gave himself. And by the way, the Holy Spirit is a part of salvation also. He is who regenerates us, makes us born again. When we give our life to him in faith, then he regenerates us. So all of the Trinity is involved in salvation, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And that's not surprising. But God gave this gift. Are you willing to accept it? A gift is only there unless, and it sits there until the person receives it. And then that gift becomes active in their life. The Bible is so clear on this. In John chapter 1, it says, to as many as received him, that is the gift, to them he gave the power to become the children of God. You got to accept the gift. If the gift just sits there and is never a part, never accepted by you, then it's a non-entity. It doesn't affect your life till you possess that gift. And it's the same with this offer. It's the same as this offer. Would you be willing to accept that gift and place your faith and trust and hope in Jesus? Okay, well, we're going to finish the verse. You know what's coming. We already said it today, but it's so meaningful, and I pray that's a part of your life. He gave you that gift. Hey, we're going to dig into more tomorrow. Don't miss it. Bye for now.